Slow commute, Kimberly.
That's right, Sion. If you can get my photographer to pan over onto the road here, you can see that it is slow going westbound on I-4. It's moving pretty well going eastbound, but you can see from, if you look at the tires, all the water that's being flung off of them. All day long, this rain has created a lot of dangerous conditions for drivers. FHP has been out here cleaning up accident after accident.
As the rain fell steadily, creating deep puddles and wet roads, flashing lights could be seen just about everywhere as troopers ran from one accident to the next.
You should really drive using caution because visibility is bad and traction is bad.
Drivers kept their headlights on while navigating the wet roads on a dark and dreary day. The driver of this flatbed truck lost his battle on the road when his truck jackknifed on I-4, sliding down the embankment, and if it had not been for this tree breaking the slide, he would have slid into the oncoming traffic exiting off at Cayley.
He's lucky. He's lucky to walk away from that.
The strong smell of fuel had hazmat crews rushing to the scene, where tires were stuck deep in the mud and the rearview mirror was torn right off of the truck.
Looks pretty nasty.
And that driver was luckily able to walk away from that accident. But this rain that's continuing to fall, it's expected to fall until tomorrow afternoon. But that's a very good thing for this area because we've been experiencing drought-like conditions. And we're going to have much more on that coming up at 5 o'clock. For now, I'm live along I-4, Kimberly Halk for West 2 News.